Shalom, and welcome to our service this evening. It's Shabbat, at which we honor our colleague and our friend, Ted Gustin, for the years and years and years of dedicated service that he has given to Beth El, but not only to Beth El, to our whole community as well. And so we're delighted that you joined us this evening in worship and in song as we celebrate Ted's contribution to our congregation. Now it gives me great pleasure to call upon our guest of honor this evening, Ted Gustin. Ted, why don't you come over to this? I'll get rid of my goodies here.
Good evening, and thank you all for being here. It's very special for me to have all of my friends and loved ones over many, many years from many, many different institutions. For this occasion, and I'm very overwhelmed and flattered to have you all here and overjoyed. As many of you probably have read the note I wrote for two newsletters ago here at Beth El, it was called A Look at Our Music at Beth El from 1969 to 2014. And between those two numbers is a dash. And I sort of capitalized on that, and I want to talk about what that dash represents from the time I came here in 69. At, I think, age 29, so now you know how old I am. What is a dash, and what does it mean? Well, it usually separates two numbers or two or more thoughts or ideas or other things. In this case, it separates when I began my work at Beth El and when I am ending it. The dash tells it all. In January 1969, I began here as a substitute organist for the then organist Patricia Northrup. Her husband, Bob, was the tenor soloist in the choir here, and he was also my tenor soloist at Christ Church in Old Town, where I also played the same time I was here, almost the whole length of that time. Mrs. Northrup asked me for her for a month while she took a brief trip to Florida for health reasons, and she decided she liked being off and not tied down so much that she asked me if I would take her job here at the temple. So Rabbi Frank was the rabbi then. She wrote him a note and recommended me for this position, and I got a letter back from the rabbi, and Rabbi Emmett Frank, telling me that first of all, he thought I was a real prima donna, and that that's what this temple needed. I wrote him a note back and says, I think not, but I would like the job. So he got all the important people together on the temple board and all, and they did accept me, and I got a letter back immediately telling me that I was going to be the new person at the organ. Back then, we had a large children's choir directed by Dorothy Rodman. The choir sang from the former cry room, that little room up there, which is where the organ is, by the way. That's where I've been for 45 years. But the organ speaks behind me through those, on each side here, behind those lights. So all those years that I've played services here, and also probably thousands, and all the High Holy Days, about 45 of them. I was up there, and the choir and the music came from down here. It was quite a challenge, and I worried a lot. But thank the good Lord, it all worked. Back then, we were all up in that little room, and the organ that we had then was from the old temple on Washington Street in Old Town. And the lady that was here then was named Marion St. John Aldridge. Some of you may remember her. She came when this temple was built in the 50s, and I believe passed away in 1962. She was very, very faithful to this place. The choir was upstairs in that room with me, a volunteer choir, and they wore choir robes, and they looked like a choir and sounded like a choir, even though there were maybe 10 back then. And we always had professional singers leading each section of the choir. as long as I've been here. Rabbi Frank left soon after I arrived. I came in January of 69. He left about August. And Rabbi Arnold Fink came on from Temple, Kenneth Israel, outside of Philadelphia in Elkins Park, Pennsylvania. I played every Friday night back then and almost every Saturday for bar mitzvahs and bat mitzvahs for about half my time here, probably the first 20 years. And the choir and all worked very smoothly, and everything seemed to work well. Rabbi Fink, if I may quote him a little bit, he said one time that I was a part of the fabric of this temple and that I should never leave. And also he said, Ted, don't forget you're not playing at the National Cathedral when you play at this temple. So don't make the organ sound like you're playing in a cathedral. So I started playing in minor keys then all the time. We were given a church model Hammond organ by the late Dr. Maxwell Sitzer in memory of his late wife, Ethel. It was certainly a step up from the old organ, and it lasted several years. And it was replaced by the present instrument we have now, which was purchased through the help of Jean Pfeiffer. Many of you remember Jean. She was a very fine organist, a member of this congregation. And the organ was, she made sure we got it in 1977. So I think it's about 37 years old now. Marion St. John Aldrich was the first organist here, and followed by a man, a very prominent organist in town named Marshall Stone, and then Patricia Northrup, and then myself. We've had about six cantors over the years, cantorial soloists. Jewish cantors. Adele Nicholson, Julian Lohr, Sonny Schnitzer, Sharon Steinberg, and our wonderful present cantor, Jason Kaufman. Our much beloved cantorial soloist for many years was Michael Peerless. Is he here tonight? Michael Peerless? There's Michael. You all remember Michael. Please welcome him, will you? And his wonderful wife, Eileen, a marvelous concert pianist. And since Michael left us, he's become a grandfather twice. And I know he's very proud of that. I think we worked together about 20 years, didn't we, Mike? 22 to be exact, okay. Those were 20 good years, really great years. Michael also sang in the choir we had upstairs, as well as serving as the cantorial soloist. Many of our singers were of great quality back then. Some of them have sung at the Metropolitan Opera, and a couple still are singing at the Met. We were very fortunate to have them. I know the Temple congregation really loved the music and loved what the singers were doing. We have had three or four new prayer books since I've been here over the years, and adjusted to them with much excitement and open minds, although some of the older members were a bit slow accepting them and the newness of them, but they came along after a while. Two large capital fund drives took place during my time here because of the rising enrollment of a religious school population and a growing congregation. We have always enjoyed the new additions at the temple and all the new space. Also, an organ fund was begun by Gene Pfeiffer, and we got a new organ during that time, which I just talked about. When we began to have Jewish cantors, the music program began to change considerably. The choir didn't sing weekly anymore, the volunteer choir, and when they did sing, they were moved to the sanctuary on this main floor, even though the organ still stayed up there. I always wanted to be a part of this group, not apart from them. And I did tell the rabbi that. I said that if they ever can move the organ down, that would be great. I would love to be down here. We started getting paid singers who sang for the High Holy Days then, and all the music came from down here in the sanctuary. And the choir sits over there in that section, and they take the pews out and put folding chairs in there. Also, the idea of using guitars and unaccompanied singing became more prominent, and the organ became less prominent. So I was playing no bar mitzvahs or bat mitzvahs anymore on Saturdays, and maybe one or two services on Friday nights. The organ has been used less and less, and as I said, it is gradually sort of fading away, but it's still here and still will be used at special times, I think. Speaking of the dash again between 1969 and 2014, it represents how the music has changed with the times. With our wonderful new cantor, Jason Kaufman, much innovative, new, and interesting music will be in store for all of us. World-class musicians and instrumentalists will be performing the music with the choir. It's all very exciting and a whole new sound for many. We're moving on, folks. We're not staying still. We hope the congregation will feel very much involved and participatory in this new wonderful leadership with Jason. Well, folks, this is all I have to say about my dash. I hope it enlightens you a little bit. But what really matters is how we live and we love one another during the length of our dashes. We never know how much time we have left to change or rearrange what we do or how we do it. I want to thank Rabbi Israel Cantor Kaufman, the temple staff, and the wonderful congregation, that's you, for the love and support you have given me all these many years. I have truly enjoyed my time with you. Thank you. I would like to introduce my niece and her husband who are here, if I could. I would also like to introduce my niece and her husband who are here from Dayton, Ohio for this occasion. Would you please stand? Tammy and Wayne Markworth.
Kid, don't go anywhere. Whoop. Kid, come back. Ted, a 45-year tenure is really something. I mean, even though we stuck you up in the box up there, first couple of years I thought this congregation, I thought it was just sort of like an angelic host playing the music here, and then I discovered Ted was actually up there. Ted, from your perch up there, you certainly have seen an amazing change in terms of not only the rabbis and the cantors and the congregation, as things have changed. And you know, if one studies the history of music, the change from going from the Baroque period into the miraculous melodies of Mozart, and then the boldness of Beethoven and all that kind of stuff, one can only imagine how those musicians felt as that transition went through. And in fact, you know, you've seen the same kind of thing happening within our congregation and within Jewish music, as it's transitioned over the last 45 years. Through all that transition and through all that change, and with all the different characters and personalities that you've had to deal with, you've always kept up that incredible demeanor, that pleasantness, and that embracing of each of us and our congregation, and that truly has been a pleasure. You said to me earlier on today that that every time you've had to come to Beth El, it's been a pleasure, that it's really been a delight to come to Beth El. And as I mentioned, that's what makes the difference between you and us.
Um,
You have truly been an inspiration to us, Ted, and your willingness to just be part of our congregational family has truly inspired all of us and lifted us through countless high holidays, through countless services, has truly raised our souls up in so many, many, many kinds of ways. And it's really difficult just to say thank you, because thank you is certainly not enough to indicate our love for you and our embrace of you. And so thank you, Ted, because those are the only words I can say. Thank you. Thank you, my friend. Now I'd like to call upon the president of our congregation to make some announcements. Linda Waller.
Shabbat Shalom, and welcome to all of Ted's family and friends and colleagues who are here this evening. Some more people who should be thanked: and Brotherhood, who sponsored our wine and cheese reception in honor of Ted, and to our women of Reformed Judaism, who've prepared the delicious oneg that we'll be enjoying in just a few minutes. That oneg this evening is in honor of Ted Gustin, our organist of 45 years, who is retiring. And Ted, we can't say goodbye to you because you're family, and you just don't say goodbye to family. So thank you for your many years of beautiful music, and may you now have the time to leisurely do what you will enjoy. And I'd like you to come up here now. And I'd also like to ask Roger Smith, our Brotherhood president, to come up here and make a presentation.
Ted, I'd like to thank you on behalf of our congregation for your contributing the music from an instrument that's only 2,200 years old or thereabouts. And on behalf of Brotherhood, the men of Brotherhood of Hebrew Congregation, as a president and a former musician in my youth in choir, orchestra, band, I'd like to make a presentation of a gift card. For a Visa gift card that has been activated.
Good to know.
Thank you.
Don't go away. Thank you, Roger, and thank you, Brotherhood. And Ted, on behalf of the congregation, I have some things for you. There are some cards that people who could not be here this evening have left, and we have a gift for you, too, that we hope you will enjoy. New organ? Well, not. It's the virtual organ. But thank you so much, Ted.
Thank you.